One of the most common growths that can occur in a person's hand and cause them to see the doctor is known as Dupuytren's contracture. That's after a surgeon a couple hundred years ago named Felix Dupuytren. In any case, it's a layer of the tissue in the hand known as the palmar aponeurosis, and it undergoes a spontaneous thickening. It's progressive. And what will happen, it will typically start with a nodule. Sometimes it's just starts off as a cord, but usually the cord develops from the nodule, and oftentimes the nodule is tender. So the person will come in, why is this knot here? It's really sore. And then they start getting the cord, and the cord can start pulling the finger down, and they can be very prominent. And if it's a dominant hand, a lot of people are annoyed because they can't shake hands. They have trouble getting their hand in their pocket. That could be either hand, of course. And at some point, it's visibly disturbing as well. If it only goes up to the first knuckle, or we call it the MP joint, it could be taken care of at any stage, just about, without any untoward problem. The problem comes in when it starts getting out to any other joint. So if it gets out to what we call the PIP joint, it needs to be taken care of immediately. Otherwise, the person will never straighten their finger properly. It's impossible. It's just the way it works out. So when the person comes in with this, if they could still flatten their hand on an object, like on a tabletop, as opposed to hyperextend it, which was normal, if they can still flatten their hand, there's probably no hurry to do anything. And we encourage them to just monitor it, because sometimes they'll just hover and sort of plateau at that. But if it starts bending the fingers down, that's a time to consider one of the three treatments. The traditional treatment is to cut out the involved tissue, which works very well in majority cases, and it doesn't usually come back if it's properly excised. The second technique is to just release the band with a needle under local anesthesia if you've been in the office. The trouble is you're not getting rid of the cord, you're just lengthening it, and so there's a high recurrence rate. The third treatment is a much more expensive modification, and I'm not in favor of that because the added expense is really no advantage. That's where you inject a chemical called collagenase. And that chemical is injected very safely into the cord. It rots through the cord over the course of 24 hours. The person comes back to your office and under local anesthesia, you stretch it and pop it. But again, equally high recurrence rate. And so I'm not really in favor of that. Really the best treatment is when a person's bad enough, just cut it out. And I consider the other two, release mechanisms to be a temporizing measure. And the one advantage to the release is if you're planning a surgery, somebody comes with advanced Dupuytren's where it's pulling the fingers downwards, sometimes it's asking a lot to be able to dissect it all out and get the fingers all straight in one surgery. So if the person is bad enough, I'll release the cord in my office under local, let them do a lot of stretching exercises, let the puncture wound heal up over the course of a couple months, and then take them to surgery and cut out everything, because that way they've naturally stretched things out and will be able to close the wound at one sitting, not have to worry about the possibility of a skin graft or rotation skin flap.